So one of those case studies Worksafe produced is on the earth-moving company Goodmans from the Kapiti Coast just north of Wellington. Goodman, it's a company that I've known for quite a while, so I know quite a number of the family members. And at the moment, Fletcher is working together with Goodmans on the Mackayster Pika Pika project, which is progressing extremely well. And we've had a fantastic one whole of project team cooperation between the two companies. So it's a family-run business and has a great story to tell about how successfully it brings workers on board. Marianne Archer is one of the directors there. She's a qualified quantity surveyor, but has focused on quality and health and safety for Goodmans since 2006. Marianne is directly involved in overseeing, maintaining, and continually improving Goodmans' business systems, including all environmental, health and safety, and quality requirements. Marianne has a belief that simple systems are the key to having an effective health and safety system within an earth-moving industry. A lot of people who choose this career are not brilliant literates, and a system could easily restrict them if it's too complicated. So to this end, she ensures a lot of photographic-based training documents and simple card systems are implemented for staff. Marianne looks after the opportunities to stay updated and regularly attends health and safety update seminars and is currently undertaking a health and safety management training through Impact. Additionally, she participated in the Worksafe review panel for employee participation in February 2015. So Marianne, please, I welcome you to the charter and to the stage. Thank you very much.
Am I up there? Yes, I am. Well, hi everyone. Thank you, Graham, for the lovely introduction. Sounds very formal. Believe it or not, I'm not a public speaker, so bear with me when I make the little errors you'll find along the way. So yes, worker engagement. Well, just to give you some context about where we come from and what we do, we're earth-moving contractors from Waikanae, which is a small place. It was humble beginnings with my dad and a bulldozer. So it's family owned and operated since 1963, which probably some of you can resonate with, being in family owned businesses. So my dad is Rick and there's four kids involved, and that's my brothers Stan, Lance, Vaughan and myself. So the five of us make up the directors, and we're all actively involved. So my dad's just turned 71 and he's still there 6 a.m. and doesn't get home before 6 p.m. And as Graham will attest to, he will still wear his stubbies everywhere he goes. So a great man. So within that group of five, I'm the director in charge of quality and health and safety and environmental systems. So it's all the compliance stuff, which a lot of people shy away from. So just to give you an overview, here we are.
Goodmans Contractors are a family business. They are the largest and fastest growing earth movers in the Lower North Island. Goodmans embrace new technology, leading the way with Trimble GPS and cloud systems, getting the job done better and faster. Good people doing very good work. Goodmans.
We don't normally do flash promos and stuff like that. It was actually for a purpose, but it served a good purpose tonight as well, to give you an overview. So as discussed, I'm here to talk about worker engagement, not because I'm an expert in this field, well, definitely not me promoting that, but because I'm passionate about keeping it real for the guys on the ground. So the boring stuff, I say the boring stuff because definitions obviously are boring for a lot of people, but engagement is how the business involves its workers in work health and safety matters and decisions. And then the participation is the ongoing ways for workers to raise their health and safety concerns, be part of making decisions which affect work health and safety, and offer suggestions for improving. Now, I saw you all switch off when I was talking about those definitions, so that's the only definitions I'll talk about. But for us, engagement and participation go together. engagement, when they're really engaged, it draws out the participation, and the participation means that your workers are engaged. We also find that staff morale is enhanced, and it's one of those non-financial incentives for someone wanting to be at Goodmans. So it can be complicated. The old Act was confusing and not very exciting. I think things are on the improve. We just had 12 health and safety reps go through the new training, and the response from them was so much more positive than it has ever been before. So I think it's a great change. I think the new guide for employee participation is still really lengthy, but it's much easier to read. So yeah, it's a good thing. However, at Goodmans, we still like to simplify it even further. So our definitions, engagement's about opportunities and pathways, and participation is speaking up via those opportunities and pathways you create. So as discussed, my philosophy, and therefore the philosophy of Goodmans and my brothers, because they get led a bit by me, is to keep it simple. The girl's always the boss, eh? And I'm the youngest too, I'm the baby, so it was bound to be that way. But we have three main systems for participation and engagement, and these aren't rocket science, and the one I'm here to talk about you in the main is the simplest of all, but we'll just run through all of them. So we have our daily toolbox meetings, which is, yeah, most people do. We take different approaches with them, so we give our supervisors a little bit of liberty. I know one of our supervisors nominates a staff member each day to come up with an interesting fact or a good joke. We have a couple of very good joke tellers within the organisation. We also do a thing called Good Answer, where we put out questions across the whole company that we want feedback on. So it might be, you notice an employee or your fellow workers just collapsed on the ground, what do you do? So we get that back and analyse it and see how we're going. Just another way of engaging them. We have our health and safety representatives, and all I'd say about this is in the past, our health and safety representatives, we sort of played lip service to it, but this year we've got the right energy on board, and with that right energy, it has driven itself. So the right people just make such a difference, and I can't emphasise that enough. So the final system is our card system. So the objective is to remove the paperwork for the guys in the field, the guys and girls in the field. And we had a lot of systems for engagement and participation, lots of A4 sheets of paper with lots of pages to fill out. So an accident, they had to fill in 2 pages, and if they had an idea, there was a 3-page form. If they, you know, there were a hazard, there was a 2-page form, and it was all white bits of paper that got lost. And as you know, there's a lot of literacy problems, and so half our guys just got to the point where they had to write their name, and that was enough. So we came up with a card system, and the difference was instantly noticeable. So instead of white bits of paper, we have these pretty colours around the place. So the idea is not to be able to see what's on these cards, obviously, but just the difference, a white sheet of paper compared to these. So now Goodmans talk a card language. We have our own special language. So have you done your yellow card means have you done your pre-start check on your machine. Have you been blue carded means have you been trained to operate that machine. Have you filled in your grey card as applying for leave. The red card is not one you want. That's like a sin bin. That's why it's red. So yeah, HR card, that one. And the green card is, have you got something to tell us? And this is the card that I'm really here to talk about, because on a friendly visit, and I say friendly, from a WorkSafe inspector, this resonated with him. He thought it was really simple. And it was his memory that then formed us being part of a case study, and that has led me here. So yeah, and the WorkSafe case study explains it best, so I'll play that and then fill in a few gaps. Goodmans is a civil contracting firm based in Waikanae, just out of Wellington. We employ 170 full-time equivalent staff. With health and safety, our whole thing is to keep it simple. The buy-in by staff is critical, so we introduced a card system where we have a green card and they just fill in one box, either the hazard, the accident,
a good idea, nominating a good person for doing a good thing. If it's health and safety related, they're given to a health and safety coordinator. He makes sure they're all followed up.
It's a great system and it works really well. The guys and girls do fill them out and they do get a response to them, whatever's happened. So it lets them have their say and they know that they're getting heard as well and issues get dealt with.
The culture change in the reporting side of things has changed a heck of a lot. I'd say it would be up probably 70% from when I first started. And that's just due to the people seeing the difference in the actual reporting is actually making a difference out in the field.
It saved lives. It's showed us where we have flaws in our system and the way we do things. And it's enabled us to eliminate those, make it safer for the guys out on site.
One of our mottos is to keep it simple. So we don't want to make anything too hard where the guys don't buy into it.
Our key is to have a culture that we all are safe and go home safe at night. So for Goodmans, it's non-negotiable that you're a part of this culture or you can't be part of the team.
So yeah, those were members of our health and safety team there, and I'm not sure the 70% was actually accurate, but that was Tony throwing a figure at it. The improvement was incredible when we introduced a card system, simple as that. So it looks, here's the card. At the front, all it has is you tick a box, you put your name, the date, you tick a box if you've got a good idea, if you're nominating a good bugger, we call it, if it's an accident, near miss, anything like that. On the back, it's for management follow-up mainly, and that's all we expect them to do. It's then taken over by whoever's investigating the accident to get all the details or to pass it on to whoever's concerned about raising that, taking that good idea further or taking the good bugger through to another thing, which I'll show you later. So the follow-up of that is what's critical, because obviously if you don't follow up with the people concerned, they're the ones that will stop buying into it. So we record it on a simple Excel register, and all the details are there, but the key is the boxes. If I point this, will that do it? Up there. Is there what's been done about it and the person responsible, and then the management review of that is what we cover. So yeah, it's all that bit. So that's not on the card, that's just on the spreadsheet, and that's how we track it. And then they're closed off and you just sort by the closed one. So very straightforward. We are looking at app-based things, but the cards will still exist because, some of our people don't even use phones very well. You know, we've still got some without smartphones, which I find extraordinary, but that's the reality. So the card system will exist. So some of the good stuff that's come from the cars, and we've had heaps of good stuff, but this is just some of them. So in the workshop, there was a set of stairs that were a bit slippery, so someone put in that idea. I mean, it seems so stupid, but it was just a way for him to get his idea through to us. Better mounting on our machines for fire extinguishers. The mechanics were driving them crazy, so they put in an idea for it. We've now got a man down app for a remote area of the workshop, which we didn't really know existed. And turned out it did, so we've now got that up and running. We have a portable air horn in our workshop for emergency response because we found out the back they weren't coming. So again, it came from someone in the workshop, not us. Dumper drivers are constantly putting in their ideas for better ways to modify their internal cabs. And good man to know cards. This was a fab idea from our HR team. When someone starts at Goodmans, they get this good man to know. And it's just got their critical sort of HR people that they need to know in those first week or so. And it's just like a business card. So other forms of engagement that we have, there's plenty, but we have a buddy system, which actually came from the green cards as well. Someone said we should have a buddy system that someone, not a manager, not a trainer, not a supervisor, but someone the new person can refer to. So that's now done, and that's a really good form of engagement. We have Facebook, social media, again, the guys love it. E-text, they get little love messages from us all the time. They're all positive, of course. We have a good answer where we put out questions, as I said, in the toolbox. And we do memos, we do newsletters, which are all a bit of fun, and it updates because we have more than one job on the go, updates across the board so that other guys can see what is beyond their little bulldozer and dumper. Well, not little, but. And we also have good buggers. These are nomination, and these come in on the green cards. We say nominate you a person who's done something exceptional for you, or just something a bit beyond the call of duty. And we give them a good bugger shirt, as you will see. That's Stu and Shay, two of our good buggers. We give them a good bugger shirt, so it's a one of a kind, or just for the good buggers. And they get a mystery envelope. And the cost of that is probably about $200 a month, but we get about 10 nominations a month. We give the nominations, we give all them a petrol voucher or something, but the feedback from that is amazing. They absolutely love it. You can't, you know, it's a real honour for them to be recognised by their peers. And yeah, it's all on the green cards. So what we've learned along this journey is that a little appreciation goes a long way. And so that feedback that you get on the green cards, respond to it. That's find out what motivates people to work and reward and engage on this level. So I say that because we get some of our workers sometimes to help with. An example is one of our dumper drivers went and did a speech at a local college with our HR lady. He was nervous as anything because he's from South Auckland and was lucky to not end up in a gang. And he said what motivates him to work is feeding his family. Great guy, fantastic worker. So we got him a grocery voucher. And the value of that is more than any other financial means. It is, it's like $50 or whatever, but it was just getting to know what level he was on, and rewarding on that level meant a lot. Tell people they're valued. Sounds stupid, but if you don't do it, it slips by. And tell people when they've done a good job. Again, sounds simple, but you can miss it. Shout smoko. They're enthused by their stomachs. I mean, we have, we're just setting up a mobile barbecue so we can do it more often, really. But for our workshop, I think my brother Vaughan shouted fish and chips last week. And the afternoon, there was singing and it was all safe, but there was good vibes in the workshop for that afternoon. It just lifted them. And this is probably the biggest one. Create the system. No system's perfect, and I'm not saying ours is perfect, but it suits the participants. So you need to create something that your talkers don't mind participating in, that your visual people can have a go at, that your practical people are comfortable with, and your listeners. It's all really important, and let them have a say via that means. And the rewards don't have to be big. Empower the right people. And find out what interests people outside of work. I'm nearly finished, which is good because I'm just coming to end of time. But this is one example of finding out what they like outside of work. In an interview, we asked what they're into, and we found out one guy liked doing videos in his outside of work. And we were brainstorming how on earth we were going to get our new induction done, because none of us are experts in video. And then someone came up with a bright idea that this guy, Chris, likes doing videos. So we said, would you mind helping us? And he took it on his own. He made up a magnet to mount anywhere on his machine. And he put together the Dumper Life, which we've shared on Facebook and stuff. And the people love it. But it just has got perspectives of filming that none of us would have come up with. And it's just because we knew that was his interest and we delved into it. So here's a little sample. Shifts in the ocean. brilliant. And I get very, it runs in the family. We all talk to our machines and give them names and stuff. We love them. So, but, you know, his ideas and the fresh approach, just because we approached him about it, has given us some footage that no one else would have thought of, certainly not us. So all I can say in summary is that when you embrace participation, and that's ideas and any other things that you can celebrate, and that you do celebrate them and respond to them, then you get engagement. And that's across the board. So keeping the system, whatever that is, as simple as possible, means that you minimise the barriers that some people face. And as I said before, a system is never perfect, so you've got to keep looking for ways to improve it. So that's all we do. And that one particularly works well for us. So I hope that that has helped in some way give you some ideas for your own companies.